Hello dear friends, welcome back. We are discussing about the structure of the human eye. In the previous lecture I have recorded about the types of rods and cones and the differences between rods and cones and what are the structures of rods and cones. We have discussed that. Now in this lecture I'm going to record about the cells of the retina, that how many types of cells are present in the retina. Now a little bit introduction of the eye, then we will go further forward and we will see all of these. That what are these? Look carefully. I will draw an eye here, right? For example, this is an eyeball, right? And you know that here will be the cornea. Then this black layer is your sclera, right? And inner to the sclera you have your choroid, and choroid when goes forward it makes the ciliary body. We have discussed it in big detail, and this ciliary body narrows further anteriorly and makes the iris, right? So what is this? This is ciliary body, this is iris, and this is choroid, which you can see in this enlarged diagram also, and I have discussed all of these in detail. Now inner to the inner to the choroid there is another layer of the eye that is called the retina. Now look carefully. Before retina, let me make here, this is your lens and these are the suspensory ligaments, and here is a chamber which is called the vitreous chamber. What is this? Vitreous. This is vitreous chamber. Now look carefully. This is choroid and this is your vitreous chamber. Now in between the vitreous chamber and choroid, there is the third layer of your eye, and this layer is the layer on which the image formation occurs. This is called your retina, right? And now the fibers from retina leaves the eye through the optic disc and optic canal and goes to your central nervous system, which I have drawn here and I will show you that. We have discussed the main points about retina. This is your retina. I have discussed the main points about retina. Then we discussed about the differences between rods and cones. Now I am going to discuss about the layers of the cells which are present in the retina. How many types of cells are found in your retina, right? So this lecture is about cells of retina. Cells of retina, right? So let us go and see the how many cells are present in the retina. This was the introduction, and I have discussed the other things regarding the retina. You can go and watch those lectures. I will give the links of all those videos in the description of this video. My dear friends, first of all, there are about 10 types of cells found in the retina. If you talk about the histology of the retina, you will find about 10 groups, 10 types of the cells present in your retina. Now let me name all those cells here, then we will put every cell in its own place. First of all, there is the retinal pigment epithelium. These are ciliated columnar epithelial cells. I will show you there, and I have drawn them here also. Then the next group of cells are the rods plus cones, which are called the photoreceptors of your eye. Then the third group of cells are called the bipolar cells. Then there are ganglion cells. Number five, there are the horizontal cells. Then there are number six, there are the emacrine cells. Number seven, there are the enterplexiform cells. Number 8, there are molar cells. We will show all of these cells, don't worry. Number 9, there are the astrocytes. Astrocytes. And number 10, there are the microglia. Microglia, which are actually the macrophages, which have been transferred here and are located in your central nervous system. That is called the microglia, and they have migrated to the retina also, and they are there to protect your retina. So how many types of cells are found in your retina? That is about 10 types of cells found in the retina. Now let's go in the detail of them. First of all, I will focus my camera here to show you all these layers. Then we will go and draw them a little bigger, and we will see all those arrangement of the cells. First of all, let's watch here. These cells that you can see, and I have enlarged them. Look, friends, this red representation shows your choroid or uvea. And now inner to choroid, there is a layer of epithelial cells, and these epithelial cells are connected to the last layer of the uveal tract, that is the Bruch membrane, right? So I will show it here also. Below the retinal pigment epithelium, there is a membrane which is called the membrane of Bruch, or you can also say Bruch membrane, right? So let's take it a little forward. This is your Bruch membrane of Bruch, and inner to membrane of Bruch, there is the epithelium of your retina begins, and this is called the retinal pigment epithelium, which contain lots of melanosomes, and these melanosomes contain melanin, and what is their function I will tell you next, right? So this is the first layer, which I have written here as the retinal pigment epithelium. Then next to the retinal pigment epithelium, as you can see here, this is the photoreceptors of the eye, and these photoreceptors are called the rods and cones, which I have discussed in the previous lecture, right? Then next to the photoreceptors, or the receptor components of the retina, there are the bipolar cells, which are actually the neurons, right? And some books says that these rods and cones are also the types of neurons, right? So the rods and cones, then next to rods and cones are the bipolar cells, right? And the bipolar cells are connected to the ganglion cells, and from the ganglion cells, the fibers are leaving the eye and are going towards your CNS and tracking the impulses there, right? And in between them, there are certain other cells, right? Like horizontal cells, like amacrine cells, like interplexiform cells, like molar cells, astrocytes, and microglia. And I will show them here in this enlarged diagram. So this is a little bit representation of your retina. The important points about retina I have discussed in previous lectures. Now let us put all these cells in their perspective places to see how the retina is arranged and how the layers of cells, how the cells are arranged in your retina, right? Now let us focus here. I have enlarged these cells, and these cells are these retinal pigment epithelium. So this is your retinal pigment epithelium. I will write it here. Retinal pigment epithelium, right? These are special type of epithelial cells. These are columnar, and they have, you can see here, they have cilia. They have outward projections of their cytoplasmic membrane. So these are called the cilia. And in between these cilia, the rods and cones are located. You can see here, right? So these are the retinal pigment epithelium. I haven't made others, but for practical purposes, we have taken the examples of only three cells, and other structures with that we will discuss. Look carefully. This is the retinal pigment epithelium. Now you can see these are special type of epithelial cells. Inside it, they contain lots of granules, and these are called the melanosomes. Melanosomes, and these melanosomes contain melanin, right? They contain melanin, and that is the pigment which absorbs the light, the extra light which comes towards the retina and will activate your rods and cones, right? And that extra light is absorbed by these retinal pigment epithelium so that not to harm, right? So that not to harm the epithelial, these rods and cones, the next layers of your retina. First, a very little bit representation of it. Look carefully here, friends. This is the retinal pigment epithelium, right? Okay, then to the retinal pigment epithelium there are the rods and cones connected, right? A little bit representation of it to have a clear concept. These are the rods and cones. Then to these rods and cones there are the bipolar cells connected. These are your bipolar cells, right? Okay, let me draw some others also. These bipolar cells, you know, we have bipolar neurons, the types of neuron, multipolar, bipolar, right? These are bipolar neurons. And these bipolar neurons, we know that they are connected to our ganglion cells, other special type of neurons. These are called your ganglion cells. Now, from these ganglion cells, fibers are going towards the nervous system. Look carefully. This is the point at which they receive the impulses, right? So this is the sensory part of these ganglion cells, and from here the fibers will leave your retina and will go to the back of your eye like this, and they will take all the nerve impulses towards your nervous system, right? So these are all those fibers which are leaving your eye. So the image is actually, look carefully, light falls on all these layers and come and cannot, the light cannot activate all these ganglion cells, the bipolar cells, whenever they reach the rods and cones. So it is able to activate the rods and cones. So when rods and cones are activated, these action potentials generated by the rods and cones, they are taken up by your bipolar cells, and from bipolar cells ganglion cells, and from ganglion cells impulses are going to your nervous system, the central nervous system. So this is the basic arrangement, right? Now let us see that arrangement here. Look, this is your retinal pigment epithelium. So first layer of your retina, the last layer, the deepest layer of your retina is the retinal pigment epithelium. Now to the retinal pigment epithelium, you can see this layer, the receptor layer is connected. So these are actually the receptors of retina, right? So this is the receptor layer, or the photoreceptor, so correctly speaking, this is the photoreceptors of your retina. So these are called what? These are your rods plus cones. So rods and cones are actually the photoreceptors of the retina. So rods and cones are connected with what? With the retinal pigment epithelium. Why it is so? Because look carefully, behind the retinal pigment epithelium, you know, you have choroidal layer, right? This is choroid, and you know well that choroid is a vascular layer of the retina of your eye, the highly vascular layer, the nourishing layer of your eye. So it contains lots of capillaries which are called the choriocapillaries, and from these choriocapillaries substances are transferred or diffused to the retinal pigment epithelium, and from this retinal pigment epithelium, food substances, energy rich substances, oxygen and glucose and amino acids and other substances are diffused to the retinal pigment rods and cones layer. These are rods plus cones layer, right? And further moving forward, so they are nourished by what? By the choroid layer, right? This will be discussed while I will discuss about the blood supply of the eye, inshallah. Look, so this retinal pigment epithelium is actually a nourishing layer, a protective layer for these rods and cones, right?
Next, so this was the first layer is the retinal pigment epithelium. Next, so this was the first layer is the retinal pigment epithelium, and these are the cells that we discussed, right? Then the next layer, the next to the retinal pigment epithelium, is your rods and cones, and I have discussed the rods and cones in big detail in the previous lecture. Then next layer of the cells to the rods and cones are the bipolar cells. So bipolar cells are actually neurons, right? Let me make them here. This is the nucleus, right? Rather, I will draw them a little bit smaller so that we have a little space. So from nuclear, from the cell body, there are two processes going, right? So these processes will make the cell body as a bipolar process, right? So we call them bipolar neurons. And these neurons come and make extensions and will connect with the rods. And they will on the other hand, they will connect with your ganglion cells. I will show them there. So what is this layer? This is the bipolar cell layer. And at some places, these bipolar cells are connected to many rods, right? Many rods, they are connected, and they give fibers also to other rods, and also, so this is the bipolar cell. And at many places of your retina, the cones are connected only to one bipolar cell. So this is the bipolar cell layer, right? Like this. This is the bipolar cell layer. And you can see here, this bipolar cell is connected here to ganglion cell, and here it gives extensions to more than one rod cell, right? So these are rod cells, as I have discussed them in previous lecture. These are your bipolar cells. Like this. And here is another bipolar cell. So these bipolar cells are your neurons, right? Like this. So this is done. The bipolar cell is also layer is also done. Now